true blue Holy Ghost, when it's the real Holy Ghost, when it's not some kind of fake Holy Ghost that a lot of people's got this day and time, but when it's the true Holy Ghost that's sent from above, your mind will be in Christ, and your mind, the carnality mind, will be gone, and you'll put on the mind of Christ, and you'll begin to live a true blue holiness life.
Hallelujah.
Before he had seen the Lord's Christ. Amen.
wasn't just a number. Amen. She was in need. Amen. She wasn't just a number in the house. Amen. She had a, my God, there was a destination inside of her that said, I've got to have it. I've got to make my way. I got to make contact. Amen. I've tried everything else. I've spent all I had. And I ain't no better off. But I'm going to try this Jesus. Amen. Your wife's coming by. I'm going to press through the crowd. I'm going to make my way. I'm going to give it everything I got. I got to touch the throne. I got to have. I got to move God in my life. And you press your way. And you reach out and you touch the very hem of the garment.
Amen.
A lot of people think, amen, they take that literally. And they say, well, that's just that's just a hymn. That's just a clothing, amen. But when you study down, amen, it was kind of like this back then. What would have been hanging, amen, and it wasn't just the garment that she was touching. Amen, but she was touching, my God, she was touching the anointing that was with him. Amen. She was touching the anointing. Amen. That was, my God, it overshadowed him. It was anointing that he carried. Amen. My God. Hallelujah. It wasn't just a piece of clothing. Amen. That she touched. But she pressed through. And she said, you know what? She might have been down. Amen. She was pressing through. And there were people around her. But she had to get in there. And she made her way. And when she reached out in that point of contact, and she pressed, oh my God, that Lord. There was something that changed that day. Amen. Jesus turned around and said, who touched me? And he said, Lord, everybody around here is trying to touch you. He said, no, this one was different. Amen. Somebody done pushed her way through it. Amen. Somebody done fought hell. Somebody done defeated the demons of hell. Yeah, I said, somebody had done got something they needed.
Hallelujah.
Come on. My God. Hallelujah. Out of everybody that was around me. Amen. There was only one that left with a testimony. Amen. Hallelujah. But when we get into the presence of God, my God, said, he said, I know mine eyes have seen the salvation. Amen. We can leave church. Amen. We can say, I know I've been in the presence of the Almighty. Amen. Because when I'm going home, I'm different from what I was when I went. Amen. But when I went, amen, I was in the natural. When I went, I was in the flesh. Amen. When I was went, amen, I still had that old mind. Amen. But on my way home, after that service, amen, my mind is gone. Amen. There's something changed. There's something different. I'm not who I used to be. I'm not the old man. He's dead now. Amen. The Bible said, amen, the old things will pass away. And behold, all things become new. We'll be a new creature in Christ. Once we've been in the presence of God, and we'll never be the same again. Amen. There's a story I was told years and years ago about a trip of people that they went overseas, amen, to the Holy Land. And on the way back, this lady began to say, I'll never be the same again. I'll never be the same again. Since I walked where Jesus walked, I'll never be the same again. I'm going to tell you why. You ain't got to hop on no plane. And you ain't got to go over to another country.
All right.
All you got to do is get in tune with God when you come. Hey, my God. Hallelujah. People talk to me about how to get the Holy Ghost. Amen. How to do this, how to do that. And I told them, I said, you ain't got to be in church. You ain't got to be in front of some fancy altar. Amen. But